The DRDO is basically the R&D establishment for defense sector in India. They have budgets of about, you know, I think about 10 to 15,000 crores annually. 20,000 crores max is what they have. But most of it they spend on doing research work. Research work for defense in various sectors, not only the Agni missiles and the Arjun tanks and stuff like the larger stuff, but also you know, important areas like you know, life sciences, where what is the kind of food that a soldier who is posted in a high altitude location like Siachen should have to ensure that his body gets the nutrition, because it's very difficult to eat you know, and then do your morning ablutions in Siachen because of the low temperatures that exist there. The morning ablutions are a huge pain, basically. Literally, it's a huge pain. So, so they ensure that the soldier eats something to keep his energy levels good and also gets nutrition. So they work on those kind of activities. There is another agency called as you know, Snow Research Establishment, which is based in Chandigarh. So SASE basically works on you know, the climate, the living conditions of soldiers and how to improve their living conditions. They have come out with the you know, solar heat, you know, heated tents which kind of ensure that you have conditions where you can, you know, live comfortably without much the habitat is very important for a soldier when he's posted in a location like Siachen. So that it works there. So there are, you know, I'm showing you the two extremes, Agni, Arjun tanks, to, you know, the food items and, you know, clothing and all that. So that is a wide range of activity that DRDO does. And there are other establishments which are called as the defense public sector units or undertakings. There are about 8 of them in the defense sector, which is handled by a department called as Department of Defense Production. It's one of the departments in the Ministry of Defense. So that all these, there are 3 or 4 you know, shipbuilders, which are defense public sector shipbuilders. Mazagon Dock is there. Then the Hindustan Shipyard in Visakhapatnam is there. Then Kolkata has one. So there are 4 of these shipyards. And there is a aircraft maker in HAL, which is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Then there's you know, Bharat Electronics, which looks at electronic products and also weaponry. And then you have BDL, which is Bharat Dynamics Limited, which looks after missiles and you know, the hard-hitting weaponry of the Indian Armed Forces. And then you have also have Midani, which takes care of the metallurgical challenges that these equipment face. So they ensure that there are indigenously we are able to make those alloys, which are quite difficult to do. It's a huge challenge. They solve those problems and provide the material. And there is also private sector companies, huge, large companies like Larsen and Toubro or Tata's. Then you have Mahindra's, Adani's are there. Then Ambani was also interested, but he couldn't pursue it much. So all these big names in the industry, then Bharat Forge. So all of them got into the defense sector and all of them are you know, getting to make some equipment or the other. Larsen and Toubro makes warships for the Indian Coast Guard. Then it also makes a you know, artillery gun, self-propelled artillery gun for the Indian Army. So Tata's are going to be making a military cargo aircraft, which they signed a deal for
right,
a couple of days back.
Yeah.
So yesterday they signed the deal yesterday. So these companies are there, and then you have these Zen Technology type of SMEs, and then you have startups like Idea Forge that I talked about, and all the rest of the, you know, in the private sector units are there. So apart from this, apart from the Department of Defense Production, you also have an acquisition wing in the Department of Defense. Department of Defense is different from Department of Defense Production. So the Department of Defense usually handles the acquisition part, the capital acquisition part of it. They take the call, they take the decision. There is a committee called as the Defense Acquisition Committee, which is chaired by the Minister of Defense. And it has as members all the armed forces chiefs, the DRDO chief, the secretaries of the departments of in the Ministry of Defense, all the department secretaries, they are all members of that committee. They take a call on, once they take a call, they have financial powers. Each of them have financial, even the armed forces have financial powers. Like the vice chief of each of the force exercises that financial power. They have a limit up to which they can take a call on a purchase, whether it's a capital purchase. Revenue purchase is an entirely different stream of purchase that is done. So similarly, the DAC has a certain power. The DAC is the Defense Acquisition Council. Then if it is beyond, say, 2,000 crore, if a value is beyond 2,000 crore, then it goes to the Cabinet Committee on Security Affairs, Security, which is chaired by Prime Minister Modi himself, and which has the Defense Minister, the External Affairs Minister, Finance Minister, and the Home Minister as the members of the committee. So this is the overall. And, you know, I told you how, that's a very simple answer to it. So all of them, when there is a proposal comes for an acquisition or a development of a product or a technology from the respective service headquarters or from DRDO, and it goes for approval, say the Department of Defense Production, and then the Department of Defense, and then it goes to the Defense Acquisition Council for a decision. And once the thing is decided, then the purchase orders are, contract is negotiated, and the purchase order is placed ultimately. So this is the how the entire process works. So there are more than 50 DRDO labs all across the country, and there is one other very important establishment called as the Ordnance Factory Board. Now that Ordnance Factory Board, which was a single unit which had about another 50 odd factories, has been now merged together and also divided into 7 parts and made into government-run, state-run corporates. Mm-hmm. Now there are 7 corporate companies which have been formed out of the these many factories, ordnance factories that they had, and they have done it in clusters wise. So one of them will make just the artillery guns, the other one will make only the tanks. Some of them will take care of only the clothing aspect of it. Some of them, one of them will take care of the clothing, one of them will take care of the ancillary items like ammunition manufacturing and stuff like that. So that is another establishment. So that comes under the Department of Defense Production along with the Defense Public Sector Undertakings. So this is how the landscape looks like.